I want to start off by talking about, you know, one of the things I've been thinking about is just this, you know, this network of, you know, successful entrepreneurs, and you've really built it. This is a global network endeavor. You know, maybe start off really quickly, just for the listeners that don't know, just the size of Endeavor, you know, the impact, the reach, and then I want to get into some of the nitty gritty with, like, you know, nuts and bolts of how this all happened and some takeaways and lessons that you've learned.
Well, it's so funny because today this seems obvious, right? So Endeavor has led the global entrepreneurship movement since 1997. Today we have over 2,500 entrepreneurs selected from probably over 100,000 screened in 40 different markets across the globe, Latin America, Europe, Asia, Africa, the Middle East, and parts of the US. I said Asia as well, right? So all totally global, and the entrepreneurs collectively have now generated, created over 4 million jobs and generate over $27 billion in annual revenue. And then Endeavor was set up as a nonprofit, which we'll get into, because 23 years ago when we were starting, no one thought there were entrepreneurs outside of Silicon Valley in the US. Now it seems so obvious, but it really, we'll talk about it, was not obvious then. I was the crazy girl for even insisting there were entrepreneurs you could find in emerging and growth markets. But today, alongside the nonprofit, we also have a $250 million co-investment fund where we co-invest in a rules-based way in Endeavor entrepreneurs, as you know, and Reid Hoffman of LinkedIn is the chairman of that. Edgar Bronfman Jr. is the chairman of Endeavor Global, and our network really spans the world as well. So that's where we are today. And also today, it seems obvious that areas like fintech and health tech and ag tech and you can actually grow and make money, right? And expand. But years ago, this also seemed like this was off this cute thing in the periphery. So it's been really fun to watch all these ideas that seemed insane 20 years ago become just sort of obvious now to the folks in Silicon Valley who are always last to the game outside their own little zip code.